Morning, little buddy. It's a very windy, cold Sunday. Or Caturday too, huh? Yeah. He acted like he wanted to go outside and try to let him out, and he wouldn't want to go outside.
He knows it's too windy, don't you? Yeah.
You like being outside sometimes, buddy? It feels actually a little warmer outside, even though it's not. Probably where. Oh, what's he doing? Is there an animal in there, buddy? Yeah, I probably wear a light jacket when I'm on the grass. If I get hot during it, I just throw it off. He's doing something. Sticking a little hole. I don't know what he's doing. Is there a mole in there you're getting, buddy? You getting a mole? You're acting like a goofy goober. I think he's just having fun. Years ago, I remember, like 2 years ago, he had his arm like in a mole hole, and he was kind of moving his arm back and forth like he was fishing for it real quick. And then he like withdrew his arm really fast and just sped off into a different yard. So that's kind of unusual. Well, I'm going to go back inside, buddy, okay? You have fun out here, all right?
Hey, buddy. Cinnabon's back in the house. Yeah, I'm about halfway done with the lawn. I think we only have one or two more cuts in for the year. That'll be nice. You don't have very many birds in here, do you? I did a quick woods walk before I started cutting the grass to identify trees that need to be down again, and there's a few more I found. A few of them I was able to just to push over. There were smaller pines. I'm gonna go ahead and get back to it, buddy, okay? Keep an eye on the house for me while I'm out there, all right, buddy? Just finished the lawn. Where's my little baby go? Where's my little baby go? Or where's my little baby at? Is he on his couch downstairs? No? I see him. He's in, wants to watch a movie, perhaps. Hey, cutie. Were you being good while I was out mowing the grass? Yeah, I bet you were. Ooh. I'm sure you were a good kitty, huh? Good boy. I gotta take a shower, buddy, okay? He looks really tired. Well, I gotta take a shower, so I'll see you in a little bit, okay? You have fun now. Hey, buddy. I gotta run a few errands, okay? And then I'll be back later. Yeah. Gonna be a good boy while I'm gone. I'm sure you will be. I'll probably go to the Dollar Tree in my adventures, and we'll see if we have anything there for you. I'm sure I'll have some wet cat food and things. Maybe I'll get a different kind to switch it up a little bit. I think he's getting a little bored with this current selection, so we'll go ahead and find something to spice things up a bit, huh? Mm-hmm. I'll be back in a little bit, okay, buddy? It's a little chilly outside today, so I got the German Flecktarn. Smock, I think that's what it's called, Flecktarn. Kind of cool German camo. Where I live, it's pretty rural, so I fit in just perfect with the camo. Plus, this is sweet German camo. You've seen this before. All right, buddy. We'll see you later. Bye-bye.
I'm in the Danger Ranger right now. Sometimes the Dr. Pepper just feels good, and that's what I got at McDonald's. What's interesting about this Dollar Tree is the parking lot, the handicap parking, is fairly far from the building entrance. The building entrance is way back there. Wonder what this is supposed to actually be. It's a good movie for a dollar. I already have it though. I'll try this too. Yeah. A couple more of these. Mm-hmm. There we go. That's good stuff.
Hey, Cinnamon, you've been hiding under the table the whole time, buddy. You've been hiding under there the whole time.
My dad always says that he probably thinks there's a little forest under there.
Yeah. You being a good kitty? I bet you are.
Anything exciting happen while I was gone, buddy?
Anything cool happen? No? Okay.
I got a new movie.
I'll show you the new movie, okay?
300, Rise of an Empire. I was going to say Rise of the Empire, but no. It's produced by Zack Snyder. He didn't direct it, unlike the other 300, so we'll have to see. For a dollar, can't go wrong.
Look, buddy. 300. Yeah. Want to watch this later?
Mm-hmm. We have to finish that terrible British movie first.
Yeah.
We also have Ghetto Doritos. I already opened them. So nacho cheese tortilla chips. They smell just like Doritos, and they look just like Doritos. Let's taste them. Let's try another one. Cinnamon's getting a drink of water.
Hey, buddy.
They don't taste like Doritos. They look and smell, but they don't taste like them. They taste like a maybe two-thirds of a Dorito, like a tame Dorito.
Yeah. What do you think, buddy? You want to try? Want to try?
I don't think this would be healthy for you, huh? So those Doritos, they very well could be made in the same factory as other Doritos, but they taste different. So what they probably do is they have the budget line Doritos and like private store labels probably buy them. And they probably say, okay, for this batch, just use 2/3 or whatever of the Dorito powder. Who knows? Can you imagine working at the Dorito factory? Frito-Lay, that's what it is. Well, I hate to end this video on a low note, but something definitely should mention. So a friend of mine has a little, I think it's called a budgie bird. I don't know if I'm pronouncing that right. Apologize if I'm not, but I put the link to her Instagram before and I'll put it again in this one. Please send her lots of love because she just lost her little birdie. So I don't know exactly what happened, but I understand the bird named Joseph Barnaby, had some problems with his legs and he went to the vet. And I'm assuming they had to put him down or he passed away some other way. So it's definitely not fun for anyone, right? I think we've all lost pets before. You know, most of us being humans, we tend to outlive our pets in almost every case, right?
Isn't that right, buddy?
Yeah. Cats live a long time, though. I know birds do, too, so that's unusual. She'll probably need a little bit of, you know, kind words, right? Who doesn't need that? So that's definitely too bad. Isn't that right, buddy? We've talked about half-jokingly doing a collaboration between Cinnamon and the bird, which, you know, obviously would probably be bad for the bird, but it was just kind of fun talking about it.
Yeah, what do you think, buddy? Yeah.
But I suppose, you know, like I've said before, we've all probably lost a pet, and it's terrible. Sometimes it feels just as bad as losing a family member, right? Because they are part of the family, or part of the pack, or part of the tribe in this case, right, buddy? Or pride, rather. Yeah, part of the pride. Being a cat, being a dog, to be part of the pack. Yeah.
I think it would be a good time for everyone just to think about all those pets that we've lost and just give them some nice warm thoughts, right?
Isn't that right, buddy?
Yeah. I think it's nice kind of reminiscing a little bit, thinking about the pets that we've loved and lost, huh? Anyway, on that note, sorry to leave on a negative note, but sometimes that's life, right? You never know.
We moved upstairs. Cinnamon's chilling on the couch / his owl blanket. I wanted to thank you all for watching again, and I hope you have a terrific night. Bye-bye.